I think that oncologists often want to, and in many cases I think should, be the primary owners of the patient care space during chemotherapy and in that immediate period when they're just leaving chemotherapy and looking to transition back into their routine care. Where I see a lot of gaps is in that transition of care. There's not a uniform way to package the data that tells anyone in the primary care space what was the treatment that the patient had, what were the chemotherapy agents, what are the possible long-term side effects of those agents, what is the patient's frame of mind, and can we put that in a referenceable document for the patient to take to mainstream back into their care. So I think oncologists can really help primary care physicians by giving guidance. They don't have to run that process, but they have to give guidance as to what should be in that data suitcase for the patients to take back to their primary care physicians. I was a primary care physician for almost a decade, and I think that many of my colleagues were afraid of post-treatment cancer patients because they were afraid of the unknown. We have to remove that fear because many patients today, about two-thirds, I shouldn't say two-thirds, but a large majority are living with cancer. And because they're living with cancer, they shouldn't have to be neglecting their other conditions such as cardiovascular, immunologic, rheumatologic, mental health, just because they're cancer patients. And we need that transition.